Another time's gotta have someone.
Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today I'm going to give you a tour of my updated small home office. My home office used to be in this armoire and I called it my home office armoire. Please disregard the chaos around it. We are still trying to renovate from the little flood that we had in our house. So I relocated my small home office upstairs in the small nook that used to be my daughter's craft nook. Now there are a couple reasons that this area works for me. One, I love the open space about it because it is on the second floor. So that's the front entry and the living room is there to the left. So I do like that it kind of feels pretty open up here. And secondly, I don't need a whole room dedicated to a home office. I do work from home. I do run a small business with my husband and I do YouTube. An area like this may not work for some of you, but for those of you who might have a small nook or even a hallway, a closet, go ahead and look at that space and determine what are the things that you need to get done. So I know for sure that I need a computer. Secondly, I know that I do need some things to file, but not a lot of things. And then I know I needed a printer and a scanner. I had a live plant here, which didn't make it to 2 weeks. So I went ahead and put these succulents that you get from the Dollar Tree and I just stuck it in the pot. This is also from Target, this lamp. I love it. It's thrifted. Just have one of my favorite pictures there of my husband and me. This ampersand, I think, was from Ross. Here is a mug. This is also from Martha Stewart for Staples. Had that for a few years. And then I also like to keep this wall here all clear. This telephone bank is from Ross. There's a slot there to put coins. I don't really use it. I like it for decor. And then you guys recognize this. This is from Target. Tape dispenser and the gold scissors is also from Target. File box, and that is for my work. Even these label holders are from Martha Stewart, and I just use my label maker to put that there. So it's stuff like this that you can use for parties. And then for these labels that are similar, I just clip them with this binder clip. And then I have this tray that's divided into three to hold some more labels. And then I have more labels down there. This is my outbox. It is for things that just need one more step. Example, a check that just needs to be mailed to the mailbox, a check that needs to be deposited to the bank, a piece of paper that needs to be filed in the filing cabinet. But it's a cue for me that this needs to have one more step for it to be completed. So this is a cubby system that I got from Target. I added the feet here. I got this white basket and the gray and white striped basket also at Target. So I'm gonna link any of the items from this video in the show notes below. And then these boxes I've had for several years. Those are from the Martha Stewart line from Staples. As far as function, I didn't want to go with all big baskets and bins because there's a lot of space inside and I would have to use smaller containers within the basket. So this is the box that holds my label maker, and you can see that these are stacked two, and this particular cubby system has this shelf that you could fit in, which I thought was great because having four boxes stacked on top of each other is a little bit more cumbersome than just having two boxes stacked on top of each other. So I thought that worked well. Okay, so this one is planner, tabs, and extra paper, those ring things, and an extra pad of paper. So this one I put at the bottom of the two boxes because I happen to grab the label maker more than I do those stuff in that planner box. My label maker, I've had this forever. It's the P-Touch Brother label cassettes. These are my crafting tools. Trust me, it's not that many. And then the stickers. Now, of course, if you are a crafter, you would be organizing differently, but you could see that there's a lot of space here to put all your crafts, even though it's a small nook in the hallway. The only way I've organized this is more of kind of the type of stickers, like the really flat ones here. Most of these are from the Dollar Tree. Then I've got kind of the 3D or puffy ones in a separate pile. This box is at the bottom of the two because it is the heavier box. They do sell labels that clip on here, but I opted not to put labels on the baskets or bins because I felt like there's already so many labels there and a label there. So just imagine this is all labeled. Clipboards that I have that I use a lot for different events. And this is a desk fan, but I'm not using it right now. some extra bags for travel, and thank you cards, and then a hole puncher, three hole puncher. All right, and then in this bin, my home management binder, my budget, my donations tracker. I just pull out to here, to the very edge, and then let it kind of lean that way. Think of everything as far as how it functions. Is it easy to pull out? Is it easy to put away? Is it something that you want in a bigger bin, or do you want it in smaller boxes? You may try what I'm doing, and then you realize after 2-3 months it's not working for you, then that's when you change it up. Old planners here, and then the pens. Love these pens. My Sharpies in this photo case, snap-ins for the Erin Condren planner. Also her highlighters. And this is my to-go planner bag. Confidential stuff, so I'm just not gonna be able to show that to you guys. And then when they're going out this way, you know, you want it to look as neat as possible. I got from Amazon. I love the nail head detail here, the black legs. Then you can see it from the back here. Now I opted for this type of chair versus an office chair. This is a table that I just got from Amazon. It's just got one drawer that doesn't actually open all the way, but it's good enough. I got these from the Dollar Spot at Target. This is Target also. This plastic cover that is actually for this. You can see I have a hairband there, earphones, and then my EOS lens wipes there, post-it notes, memory cards, extra plug, another post-it note. This cleans the screen also. These are large gold binder clips. Here are some more gold office stuff like thumbtacks, command hook clips, paper clips, and more mini binder clips. A highlighter and a gold pen. I got this from Staples, Cynthia Raleigh line. It's a very minimalist looking calendar. This holds my cell phone. This lamp is also from Target. And then I have a couple of my favorite pictures of my kids here. Here I have my iMac, Sony speaker, and then I do have a clock here. My Snowball microphone here for when I record voiceovers for my YouTube videos. Just got this backpack camera bag because we are going on a trip. My husband will be using this, so it's here for now, but normally it's not there. Once we were done with that, I'll go ahead and put it away with all the other luggage. This is a cubby system also from Target. It's only the two cubbies, and I decided not to have the legs on there because of the height of the printer. I didn't want it to go above the ledge. I've had that for years. The paper doesn't fall down to the ground, and you can just tuck it away. And then I have here stamps, deposit slips, envelopes, and checks. Next, I have my stapler there, and then I have a woman's devotional Bible. That's a great Bible to read. And then I just have a little helmet there with my alma mater cowl. These are address stamps, and then these are used ink. One of the things I knew that I needed to get organized was my camera stuff. I don't have a lot, but I have enough where it needs to be organized. My camera usually sits in there. I have my mini bag for, you know, short trips. The thing that holds your phone if you're gonna film with your phone. And then I love this basket at Target. I love the texture. I love the color. I love this little fringe there. I needed something for my tripod, so you can see my tripods are there. This is my laminating machine. There's kind of a space here. That is where I keep this little contraption. And then we have the bigger paper cutter. I've even labeled it paper cutter. See the label from up here if you're looking from here. Because the space has been decluttered and organized according to the functions that I need it for, it usually stays like this. I hope you guys enjoyed this video of my updated home office in this hallway nook. Let me know in the comments below what's working for your home office. If you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. Make sure you also subscribe because I will be showing a couple more areas in my home that are organized and functional for me. I hope you enjoyed and found this to be helpful, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. If you'd like to support me on Patreon, the link's below.